Hey guys, what's up? It's your girl Lisa from Smooches Makeup Artistry. Today's video is all about breast cancer awareness. I wanted to just show you guys a look that I deem as being wearable. I don't normally do pink eyeshadows very often, but I wanted to use my favorite pink eyeshadow and just kind of play off of that. And recognition of Breast Cancer Awareness Month. There are so many diseases and things out there that really need recognition and awareness, but my suggestion to everyone is to basically know your body. Get to know your body. When something is not right and you know it's not right, you need to get it checked out. Early detection is a lifesaver. So I definitely believe breast cancer has hit home to many of us. My mother was affected. She is now 6 years breast cancer free, and I am overjoyed. I remember it like it was yesterday getting that call, but we have come a mighty long way and our faith has brought us through some tough times. So I definitely just want to give a shout out to all of those who are going through it, who are dealing with people or have relatives that are going through it. Definitely get yourself checked or check yourself on a regular basis. You have a boo or a spouse, I'm going to say a spouse, have them check it for you. You know what I'm saying? It's okay. You need to find these things out. I hope you guys like the look. My camera did pop off at one time, but yeah. Let me see if I'm posting. This is out. This is clear. But this is the look. What I'll do is I'll put a few pictures up once I get outside in natural light and you can see it and hold the rest. If you have not seen my video when I got my hair straightened, definitely check that out. I'm going to link that below. I got it professionally done. And it's been since Friday. Today is Tuesday. I put nothing on it. I've added no oils, no anything to it. And homegirl hair is still doing its thing. It's been raining like all weekend, but yeah. I'm definitely happy with the health and the growth of my hair. So that's a blessing. You know, my channel is all about hair care, makeup, you know, a lot of different things, but the main focus is on hair care and makeup. But I just wanted you guys to see that my hair is still hanging in. I don't know if I can do it up a little bit to show you. All right, thank you guys so much for watching. And again, if you're interested in this tutorial and see what products I use to come up with this look, stay tuned. Mwah, smooches. Be blessed, guys, and most importantly, be a blessing. All right, guys, let's get started. I've already done my brows, and if you want to see a tutorial on how I do them, click the link below. Now onto my eyelids, I am going to prime them as usual, and I'm going to use the MAC Paintpot in the color Painterly. I'm going to apply it all over my lid and a little bit above my crease. I always let you guys know that priming your eyes before you put eyeshadows on is a lifesaver. It's going to increase the longevity of your shadows and it will avoid them from creasing. Now I'm going to take this beautiful pink from Woodstock and I'm going to apply that all over my lid. I'm just patting it on because I want the color to be very concentrated and very in your face. And I think because this color is so vibrant, I'm not going to do too much with the eyes. It's going to pretty much speak for itself. I'm going to let the pink do the talking. Now I'm going into the Wild at Heart palette by BH Cosmetics. And I'm going to take this beautiful iridescent rich purple and I'm applying that to the outer corner of my crease. This is just going to give my eyeshadow a definition, a dimensional look instead of just looking really flat with one color. Right there, I'm just dragging it out a little bit. Before I go to blending, I'm going to go ahead and use a color for a highlight. And I'm going to my Naked 3 palette, and I believe this is Dust. And I'm going to use that for a brow highlight. I'm just applying that right under the brow. And next is my It's Judy Time palette. And I am going to pull out that beautiful light brown. And that's also from BH Cosmetics. And Judy is one of my favorite vloggers. I just love her and her family. And what I'm doing with that color is just blending everything out seamlessly and giving it a polished look. For my eyeliner, I'm using the MAC Blacktrack, and that is called the Fluidline. So I'm just applying that right to my lash line. I love this liner because exactly where you put it is where it's going to stay. I love it. Now I'm just going back in with some of that pink just to make it stand out a little bit more. And onto my mascara. My first coat is going to be the Maybelline Flared Mascara. I believe it's something else, but I'll put that down below. For my waterline, I'm taking Feline from MAC and applying that right to the waterline. And for my second round of mascara is my favorite, MAC Zoom Waterfast. And that is, and I believe just black is black or black. I don't know. I'll put it down below. Now for my actual foundation, I'm using the Studio Fix by MAC. And I'm using a flat kabuki brush, and I'm just applying that all over my face in circular motions. And this, I find, is one of the easiest ways to apply my foundation. I don't like too much makeup or too heavy, and doing it this way gives it a nice airbrush look. Now for contouring, I'm just going to take this beautiful color. This is a MAC palette, and I believe this is Definitive. Just applying that right to the hollows of my cheek. And that was a custom-made palette, so it's just different things I put in there myself. And I'm going back into that same palette, and I'm pulling out a blush, and that is called Salsa Rose. It's very pigmented, so you really need to be careful. And right there, I'm just blending it out because I don't want it to look too overpowering. And for the lips, I'm aligning them with Process Magenta. I did start off with a lip primer by NYX. That's already on there. And so you guys know, my camera did stop right after I applied the liner. And I'm going to list my other two products that I used on my lips below. So I used a total of three products. I'm sorry that my camera stopped, but I will list those products so that you will be able to get the same type of result. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe and follow me on Instagram. Mwah. Stay tuned for pics. I don't know why people do this. I feel really strange when I'm like, see my makeup? You see? Do you like it? If you like it, then stay tuned. All right, guys. Take care. Smooches. I'm going for real now. Mwah.